Aww. Don't forget to retweet the room. You guys know that we give out just...
Wake up!
Why now?
We'll let you up. If you go wiling out, though, we'll just kick you straight back down.
No wiling out on Saturday morning, that's for sure.
Welcome, everybody. The Noun Square for 9 o'clock. Light. Weekend light. We call it light because we usually have guests on for the normal show, but for weekend light, we just get here about 5 minutes before FOMO. We have about 4.5 minutes until we actually play FOMO Nouns. Is a game we all play together here to help mint the very next noun. So I'm going to go ahead and get those links pinned to the top here. Just go ahead and open up fomonouns.wtf right in your browser. And the other thing I have opened is nounoclock.app. So that's our new front end from the Noun Square here. And it's a really fun way to sort of watch the nouns bid. I mean, we get to see these little notes that people do. We get to see the next pending bids as soon as they come in. So that's...
which we just got to see. Got a 67.23 pending bid. I don't know if it's late enough to extend the auction. We'll see in a second because it's at 4 minutes now, so it might extend.
So what are you seeing? 67? I'm not seeing that.
Yeah, 67.23.
Weird, it's not showing for me. 142. Bug report.
Ah, there's a bug. It's not, you're on mobile, probably. It's on the right side. If you scroll to the right, I just captured that too.
No, I'm not on the. I'm not on mobile. It's
because someone did a 69 bid.
Now there's a 69.79.
I see that one, but the 67 never showed up on my.
Yeah, they've disappeared now. Yeah, so I guess they failed. So I think that was something that was happening. The pending ones were showing, and now they don't.
Interesting. But mine never actually even showed us pending. It just showed up as 69.79. Bam. It's there. Anyway.
Right.
It's a good bid.
Yes, sir.
I think if that higher bid gets put in like nearly at the same time as the other one, it just knocks it out.
Yeah. If the other one fails, it doesn't show up anymore. I believe that's happening. I think Sam was saying that the other day. His one failed and then disappeared. Well, there you go.
The 0.01 bid. It's definitely
I'm a little bit sad that all of the bidders today have not left their messages. Like, what are they doing?
It's okay. I think as they say, Ben, that means we're early or something.
Yeah. Are you looking at FOMO screen right now? There's an amazing combo with a baseball and a bell. And it's like the bling bell. So good.
This has been Ben Explains FOMO Badly.
We haven't had enough meme contests lately. I got to explain something badly.
Well, do we have a first contest right now that we can remind everybody about?
We sure do. Would you like me to tell people about it?
I would love that.
Do it live.
All right. Well, we have a really cool contest going on right now. We'll pin it to the top. But the idea is that Sir Nodes went through and picked through all of the noun heads that we have yet to mint in NounsDAO. 39 total noun heads. We've got them on the graphic, and you just need to pick one of them, whichever one speaks to you, and do a piece of art based on it. It can be in any style. It can be in digital style, whatever you like to do, pixel art, non-pixel art. It can be a drawing on a napkin. It can be a painting. Yes, it can be a semi-solids, whatever you want, whatever medium you prefer. You make that noun head or noun with that noun head, and you submit it with the quote tweet. You can enter as many times as you like, And each time you enter, you're also entering yourself in as a guest for a bounty contest, so that if FOMO mints that noun head in the next, I guess, 4 days, 5 days until next Wednesday, you will get a bonus prize of 0.069 up to a maximum of 5 bounty prizes. So that should be super fun. A little bit of art, a little bit of roulette. That should be fun.
I love that. So many bonuses here. If people are just paying attention, there's just every opportunity in the world to not only maybe get your art out there, but to get a little bit of ETH every now and again just by hanging out here at the Noun Square.
You love to see it.
45.
I'm trying to find the tweet with these unminted heads. I can't find
it. Oh, I posted it. Cool. Unminted heads tweet, yes. I just have the contest tweet.
Oh, nice. I'm just searching for nothing.
Can I just comment on our friends at Nouns News? They're down there, and that logo is new, I believe, and it's so sick. See do you see the noggles with the whatever you call that, the test screen?
Yeah, I love
that. That's awesome. Very cool.
Everyone's been getting very creative with their noggles lately. I love those Nouns News ones, and I love like Woody's, the piano ones that we saw the other day for the first time.
Yes, they're amazing. We got another bid, a 71.19 pen. Here it is.
It's in
again, and a good pirate ship. Well, let's talk about what we're looking to mint as well. I believe, this is not going to win you the contest, but we need a wizard hat for Wizards DAO. Like, they're in the market for a wizard hat, so there's a little bit of conflict here because there already is wizard hat been minted. But if we can mint that, then, you know, we're going to have some happy customers.
We could think about it.
I don't see many wizard hats pop up during FOMO, to be honest. Like, in the last couple of months playing it every single day, there hasn't been a lot of wizard hats.
Looks rare.
I don't even think I've seen one.
Does look
rare. There's been like two or three, but not many.
Yeah, it's very rare.
They were probably with really ugly combos.
Yeah, exactly. Everyone just like blocks it out.
We need that magic, you know?
I want to see a hanger too. Piano, the hanger.
We've gotten close to the hanger a couple times.
Yes.
We did get an airplane, so we should get a hanger next, right?
Yeah. Or a helicopter. We need a helicopter still too.
Helicopter.
And the
we don't have an orangutan either.
That's crazy. I know. I was going to say, I literally was about to say the orangutan. I had no idea.
I love the orangutan. I don't know why people always like give it shit.
It's crazy. I'm surprised some of these heads haven't been minted because we see a lot of crane. Some of these. Yeah, the crane's cool too.
Maybe we can mint an animal head, a capybara, a crane, or an orangutan.
Yeah.
I know. I think we've been actively boycotting the donut ever since the incident with Big Donut in California.
Oh, 142. Yes. I like your little wizard hat. Is that that's got to be a nodes?
Yeah, if your nose, your nose.
Oh wow, that's a great one.
Nodes.
The rare cool wizard hat.
The second nodes minted ever.
Ooh, oh, wow. Look at Clippy pulling in another bid.
Ooh. This is a really clean noun, I'm not going to lie. I mentioned yesterday on the show, this is one of the only nouns that could almost be printed in the inside of the newspaper. So, very rare.
Yeah.
Almost fully grayscale.
So good. It's super clean. I love it.
Super cheap to print, too. Like, if you wanted to print posters of your noun. These are
advantages. Yeah, exactly. Not too many colors.
How many colors are you using? One?
yeah. There's interesting, the top bidder now is 74.97, has 0.03 left in their wallet. So that's their last bid for now, unless they top this wallet up. So let's see if the other guy is going to take them out. And I don't know who either of these wallets are, to be honest. No,
I think it only has 0.05 in it, too.
Yeah, they're really scraping the bottom of the barrels here.
That's it. They're at the end of their budget for the...
Mm-hmm. They're probably just hoping this person is not on the nounoclock.app site.
Well, he bid. That's true. But he bid not too long ago, so I don't think he's out of it. I think we're definitely going to see another bid for A6. Otherwise, he didn't really want this noun, because if he checks the wallet and sees that there's only, 0.03 ETH left, I mean, why wouldn't you bid, right?
Is Clippy our groundhog for Noun's winter? Like, is it over? Because
I think we survived, to be honest with you. And I mean, we've talked about this on the show, how Noun's winter is definitely a North American construct. And, we've had no problem with 100 plus people every night on this show and into the morning. So definitely not really a Noun's winter. But there was a bit of a hit to the price for sure of Noun's. And it seems to be bouncing back. So that's good.
Yeah, I guess that's where I think it was one of the guys, I can't remember which one, on the OpenSea spaces with the five people from Nouns. I can't remember who said it, but one of them said they were waiting for a while and couldn't get in, and they took advantage of that early morning EST time zone and managed to get in for a decent price because of it.
Yeah, I can't remember who that was either. I was thinking it was Yutong, but then later I think Yutong said they don't own a noun yet, so it couldn't have been him. But yeah.
Maybe it was Jacob. I'm not sure. Oh, no, it was D. The guy D that works with Jacob.
Oh, yeah, I think you're right.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah, because he was looking for the boot originally, which was funny. Did you?
The best deal in nouns, the boot.
Did you guys, did everybody tune into that? It was really interesting. I didn't hear anything about it, and then all of a sudden, bam, it was like, oh, nouns, by the way, we're going to be on OpenSea's Twitter spaces. What? That was yesterday at 1 p.m. Who all tuned in by show of emoji?
I just listened to it just then. I had 30 seconds to spare between that and then this space. It was like right on time.
That's funny. Yeah, it was an interesting conversation for sure. It definitely seems like nouns are going mainstream.
Yeah. Well, I mean, that had, 2,200 people, something like that, have tuned in at this point. It was interesting how they ran it, like OpenSea hosting and not saying a word. And then they pull up a co-host who obviously handles pulling up the speakers, and the co-host also not saying a word. They pull
seems
up
like a familiar seems like a familiar model, doesn't it, Ben?
Well, I mean, we're as hosts and co-hosts on our stage, we typically are the ones that like guide the conversation, have a chat, and all that kind of thing. Whereas theirs, it was just speakers the whole time.
Yeah, for sure.
Oh, no. Oh, that's seconds. A good orangutan. Dang it.
Yeah, these almost two top bidders are out of each. Hi. The other one can't outbid him unless they top up. This is it. We're playing. We go. 1 second. Orangutan.
Oh my god. Like, yes. Please.
That's not what I meant to do.
That was the pull up, not the.
Are we
ending that quick?
Wait. Rewind.
Time for FOMO.
That's what I meant.
Nice.
There's no pull up. No, you didn't miss the pull up. It's going to be later.
You need another sound exactly like that. This is just kidding.
That's just cruel. Right, you got a CD off the bat.
Ugly.
For those in the audience who don't know what a CD was, I can't help you.
For those in the audience not yet joining us, please go back to that open tab in your browser, fomonouns.wtf.
Also, are y'all looking at the nounder now?
Yeah, I'm watching both of them.
And how do you do that? You go up on the right side where it says active players, and you toggle where it says show noun.
Ooh.
430.
Yeah, so that's, that's
I didn't know that feature.
That's a fancy honk there.
Yeah.
It used to just show them both by default, and it doesn't anymore, but you can still toggle it.
Toggle. And if you forget which one's the new noun for the day, it has the gavel beside it, which currently it is a gavel, so that's kind of confusing, but.
Yeah,
it's awesome. It's just a tool tip there to show you that this is a gavel noun.
It's knocked its retainer out with a gavel. Like a retainer between two gavels.
Wait, that's not a retainer. Is it? I thought that was an aardvark.
It's an aardvark.
Yeah.
I think it's an aardvark.
Oh my god. That's an aardvark.
Can't unsee.
It looks exactly like the retainer head, but as an accessory.
It does kind of. I'm sorry that they couldn't draw a better aardvark in 6x6 pixel, Ben.
Yeah. Sorry to the pixel artist who used 7 pixel square to do that.
Ooh, that's quite a festive hot dog.
Oh, I like that rabbit.
He's got bun noggles.
That was like the bun noggles.
I'm partial to the rabbit. I'm always voting yes when I see the rabbit.
Yeah, it's a nice rabbit. I like all the rabbit heads, eh?
And that's because he's your favorite rapper, right, Joshua Fisher?
Mm-hmm. Yes.
From 8 Mile? Yeah.
Yes.
Be rabbit.
Better. Lose yourself in the moment.
We should get a combo here of Beauty Rabbit and Spaghetti Head. Mom's spaghetti now.
Yeah, if we got a rabbit.
Oh man.
We need spaghetti with the mess on a sweater.
Oh, that would be amazing.
We'd have to get Eminem to buy it if that.
We're getting so picky now. We're like, we need a narrative between the two nouns.
Yeah, there has to be lore.
We got two voids at once that never recovered. That's what happened.
It's true. We're chasing that high again. We'll never get there.
Well, Ben, now you know that you can get a double aardvark. So that's pretty crazy.
Yes. Oh my god, this is a good combo too.
Ben would have been like, oh my god,
our dream of Yeti?
Ben would have been like, oh my god, aardvark retainer. It's amazing.
Aesthetically pleasing trash cans I've ever seen.
Yeah, this is the
Eve trash can, I would totally
vote that. Scale. So good.
When
don't be a phone! That's so good!
We're about to get it too. This is good.
I hope so.
Even my dogs want this one.
Yeah, dogs usually don't react too well to UFOs.
Hey, we got it!
Wow.
Nice.
That was a fast FOMO.
That was.
Cool.
That's why we call it Fast FOMO Saturdays.
Do we do that now?
Well, we call it light, you know.
Oh,
we have a lot of terms going on. We also have the fat free or low fat edition.
Low fat, yeah.
Yep, of our spaces that we've been doing here.
Yay!
Aww, that was so cute.
Robot no, fish girl.
Was that a mini now?
It is a mini now. So
yeah, okay, I'll clip it.
It's alien.
Clip it in.
Spaceship.
A spaceship.
Oh my god, stop it right now.
That's the cutest little spam I've ever heard.
It is. No, it's a little wizard.
Yeah, it's a little wizard node.
Oh, yeah.
That's why it's a wizard PFP today. Because we have a guest.
Oh.
Does our guest want to be interviewed?
Yeah, are they interview ready?
Yeah, sure. Can you answer some questions?
What is their favorite noun?
What's your favorite noun?
An Ehrenmann skateboard.
Skateboard noun.
Oh my gosh, me too.
he's gonna get his the small finger skateboard that he got from New York.
Nice. I have that right in front of me.
I still have to assemble mine.
It's been like 2 months.
Wait, how much assembly was required on these things?
Just some.
It wasn't zero by any.
There's tiny tools, okay? I was scared.
Oh, damn.
Got it.
Noun skateboard. Oh, my God. You even noun-pilled your children. I love this.
Of course.
Do they like Zarg's PFP?
Let's see. Yeah. Do you like this one? Yeah. Yeah? Uh-huh. It's a small skateboard.
That's my little skateboard.
We do it for
the
kids.
It's a little skateboard.
Big. I've got one of those too, Zargs.
Mm-hmm. Yay!
In my world.
You have a little skateboard head?
I do. I had to swap it out for a little toady, but yeah, I do have one.
I want to run them a trick.
See, I posted earlier that Saturday night or Saturday morning FOMO is the new Saturday night. Wow, Saturday morning cartoons. So see, it's obviously true because 142's kids are here watching FOMO instead.
More fun than cartoons.
That's right.
This is the new normal, right? I think there'd be more education and more fun.
What was that, 142?
Mini 142 says that it's the same, that his skateboard is the same as Zark's.
Oh, cool.
I like that little 142.
My brain was just like 71.
There's so many friends here for little 142. Yes, it's 71. Little purple,
I have two 71s here.
Little turquoise panda.
They can't see it now. They can't see it. No video yet.
Yet. Bum, bum, bum.
Fun stuff.
We can get little 142 on the next video with the snap filters. Do a little interview.
We need the double filter.
By the way, we've got a new long form video that's going to be going up on YouTube this morning. So keep an eye out for that. A few of us got together and chatted about all things Nounish the other day. And Super Tight Woody did a nice edit, pulled out some clips that we've been posting over the last couple of days. But we're going to post the full 1 hour conversation on our YouTube. If you want some Saturday watching, that'll be coming up soon. And of course, this was live streamed to YouTube as well. So if anyone missed it, you can either share the Twitter Spaces recording, or you can just point them over to our YouTube where they can watch it live with some nice visuals, watch the auction and the FOMO. It makes them feel a lot more like they were there if they were. So sad to have missed us this morning.
I know. I feel like I typically feel like this on the light days, but I mean, FOMO was really fast today. We do have a little bit of time here with each other. Is there any updates in the nouns world that we absolutely need to know about? Anybody? I'm trying to rack my brain. I feel like I did learn something really cool today. Maybe it was like the open sea space that I was at.
We're starting to see some little clothing stuff come in, and that's been looking pretty cool. I don't know if you guys are launching like the Nouns brand clothing stuff. It's pretty cool.
Yeah, I have. I saw that cardigan.
I want the merch. So the merch.
I also noticed the Nouns Discord got like a nice little sort of reorganizing. I liked that.
Yeah, you don't have to scroll down for a million years before you reach Noun Square.
I did notice that too. At first, I was like, what's going on? I was like, trying to scroll. It's just the props. I'm like, was I kicked? It happened.
They're like, we've had enough of this up, Toshi.
Oh, this is awesome. I hadn't even noticed.
Yeah, it looks really good. I think 9999 was the one who was working on that. They did a great job, I think.
Got apps category. Yeah, this is good.
Yep. The proposals were sort of separated out from the ones that are sort of active channels versus not so active.
I feel like Nouns AI and Roko beta testing could be together without writers room between it because they're like the same thing almost.
But the rest I don't know why. Awesome. I don't know why proposals weren't at the bottom of the Discord already from the get-go.
Yeah.
It's kind of weird. It was weird that they were near the top to begin with. But yeah, this is definitely cool.
It feels good to have a promotion of Nounsel popping up the side there. That's awesome.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah,
I feel like Nounsel as a role should be on the sidebar as well. Like they should just jump into the roles and click that little button that says display this role in the sidebar. So Nounselers get a category on the sidebar because there's like NounsDAO Rinkaby category. So
yeah,
you know, Nounselers should get one too, I think.
I think so, too. There's been a lot of changes for the better in the Nouns Discord recently, though. So one thing that got turned on last week that nobody really talked about is they finally gave mods the ability to set Discord events. So that's been pretty cool. When Aptoshi and I did our Ask Us Anything on Tuesday, they were able to put an event, and it got us like an extra 30 or 40 people in based on the previous week just from having that event up, because it shows a little notification in the sidebar if anyone's in Discord but they're not in the Discord that shows an event, and it draws people in. So it's a small thing, but makes a big difference. Right.
Yeah, great.
If you're in the Noun Square Discord, you'll see the event icon right now.
Yeah, exactly. Ben's,
there you go.
Ben's been doing an awesome job of keeping those up to date.
Well, thank you, sir.
Speaking of events, why don't we talk a little bit about Soapbox? It was our first week for Soapbox, and I think it's been a great success. We just had three this week, and we've got at least two more that are being added next week. We're having a Sharks Soapbox coming up on Tuesday. Nice. Just confirmed that with Cryptasha yesterday. Yeah. And we've got one other one in the works that I'll keep under wraps for now. But looks like we'll likely have about five soapboxes up from three next week. I did a little bit of number crunching yesterday, and over a two-day period that when we launched Soapbox, we had over 550 people tune in to all of our spaces, including 9 o'clock and Soapbox, in just a couple of days. So I'd say that obviously our community is enjoying this so far, and there's been some good cross-pollination between the different groups that have come on. If you're new to Soapbox and you don't know what it is, essentially it's a very simple initiative that we just launched where any Nounish community can basically come and commandeer the account to run their own spaces from the Noun Square and introduce your own community to the Noun Square and vice versa. And this week we had one from Food Nouns kicking it off on Wednesday night. And then we had Lil Nouns and Lil Sisters on Thursday, almost back to back. And it was super fun. We had some giveaways. I see Lily down there rocking a little macaroni. She actually won that live on the Soapbox for Lils, which was pretty cool because Lily's been around our spaces quite a bit, and she usually has a different PFP, but I don't think she had a little noun before that. So literally introducing people into new communities.
Such a cool little macaroni too, with like the shirt underneath it, sunsetting up into it kind of thing.
Yeah.
Gradient. So good. Yeah, we're polling the NAS community at the moment, trying to figure out the best time to do a NAS episode each week, but there'll be a NASDAO episode that we'll confirm in the next few days. Awesome. Everyone values their weekends in NASDAO. They go skating. So you're not gonna get much Discord response on like business during the weekend. Everyone's literally skating.
Well, keep in mind that right now we don't have any soapboxes on Monday or Friday. So if there's any chance of you know, that, and I'm talking about EST time zone when I say Monday or Friday. So if there's any chance of that, I guess Saturday probably won't work for the Aussie skaters, but maybe Monday. Yeah. So which would be your Monday night or even into Tuesday. So.
Yeah, that's right. I figure the best timing is probably my like evening EST, our mornings over here, because then it's kind of it works for a lot more people, because I don't want to make it so that it's kind of cutting off anywhere in the US. I think there's going to be a big crowd from the US that should be a possible time for both, you know, over here and over there. Makes sense. Like a 3 or 4 hour window that would work, I think.
I've been highly impressed by everyone's run of show for these different soapboxes. If anyone gets the chance to sort of even just tune back in, they're all recorded. I would definitely go and listen to and maybe even grab and download the ones that are your favorites so that they just don't get lost in the mix. But, you know, everyone's show has been so Nounish and then also extremely unique from each other. And so we've seen these great communities come together almost with even the community that exists here with the Noun Square. So these shows have been running these solid at least 1 hour, you know, segments, and they are great shows. And so I really encourage you guys to show up to any one of these soapboxes and get the chance to learn a little bit more about a different Nounish community.
I had a lot of fun with that first Food Nouns one, and like, what a guest. I'm still like kind of starstruck that we're speaking with Louis Lombardi. I was like, whoa, this is crazy. It's so like, it's kind of surreal, man. Like, we're to think about what we've done at the Noun Square in the space of like 2 months or just over 2 months now, I guess, it's crazy. We've done a lot of things and achieved so many goals, and like, we barely take a second to give ourselves a pat on the back, and then we're like, all right, continue on, keep building. And we just don't stop. There's just not more to toot and more our awesome own stuff horn, happening.
Right? Not to toot exactly. our
own horn. No, not at all. And I don't think we do. You know what I mean? I don't think we even really take time to think about all the things we're achieving before just using that as a platform to just keep building on top of. You know, we're just like, all right, well, that foundation's set. Let's keep moving. I think it's awesome.
Yeah, and we get to participate in the Nouns governance ourselves because of 142. Thank you again. I hope your little 142 knows that they get to sort of put in a vote there as well. But that's always exciting during these times where we have these. I feel like sometimes you'll have these weeks where a ton of props come on chain, and then you'll have these other weeks where there's sort of a lull. So we have one of the exciting weeks where we're going to have a couple new props here. Nouns.wtf, if you go up and click the menu and hit DAO, you'll see three brand new props that are showing up. I don't know if anyone sort of wanted to talk about that, but I just thought it was a good segue. You know, since everyone here will definitely be able to have a voice, since 142 is noun, we get to vote with that noun here.
Yeah, speaking of these votes, we've actually got the first one available for Prop 134, liberating the proposal threshold for 26 years. So
what's this all about? Maybe we can ask 142 to explain this proposal, because it's an interesting one.
Although it's a bit noisy. So basically, there's a threshold set for submitting proposals to the DAO. And it's a percentage of the number of nouns exists that have been minted. And it's basically, there's a configuration that sets the percentage point. And it's been, since the beginning, there was like three times that you would only need one noun to put a proposal up, but it was set to go up after a few months because of the percentage point, which was high, like higher. So you would have one, you would only need one noun to put a proposal up, and now you need two. So if you have one noun, you can't really put a proposal alone. You need to band with another nouner or have a delegation of another noun in order to put a proposal up. So it makes it a bit harder to put a proposal up. And this proposal by Nifty Knot says, hey, let's reduce the threshold to one proposal, one noun per proposal for up to like 10,000 nouns, which is about 26 years. So that's the proposal. We can always have another proposal to put it back down. So it doesn't really matter how many years. It's just the point that by default today, if this proposal passes, we'll always need only one noun to put a proposal up, unless we change it.
And currently it's sitting at two nouns. So it'll actually allow approximately 80% of noun holders to submit props again that have been kind of locked out from being able to do so with just their single noun.
Well, funny enough, we ran into this when we were trying to put up our second proposal for an extension from vote.thenounsquare with 142's noun. And we were like, what's going on? It's not working, because it was just after we hit 400 nouns. And the reason we couldn't post it that way is because we only had the one noun delegated to that wallet. So I can definitely see it being a friction for certain nouners who want to put something up. And it's not as simple as just saying, hey, 142, can you co-sign my prop? Like, they have to actually delegate the noun to your wallet in order to be able to put the prop up, I believe. Yep.
Exactly. Yeah, so it does make it some friction. And so the arguments for this are that most nouners, like, we haven't really had spamming proposals. So there's no really reason for our bad proposals, like really malicious proposals. So there's no really reason to add this friction. And so that's an argument for. The argument against is that it's just basically 26 years, so it's way too long, and we should just extend it for maybe a year or two and then see. But
the funny thing is, I feel like he was trying to be funny. I feel like he was trying to be funny in a way, Nifty Knot, when he made the 26 years or 10,000, because he knew when he made the proposal that the time is arbitrary, because like you said, it can be changed back at any time. So it could have been 3 months or you know, 26 years. It didn't really matter. But I've already seen at least two reasons no voted on this because of the years, which is kind of funny.
I think it's optics. And the kind of like wanting to have a default that does increase over time. So that's why Will Price, for example, voted against, I think. So, and he said he would vote for an extension of 1 year. I don't think it matters at all. Me personally, I'm in favor of keeping it at one noun. for proposal because it gives more opportunity for diversity and reach for people that don't have more than one noun.
But as it stands, can one noun, you could still vote, right?
Yeah, you can vote with one noun, just you not just submit vote. Proposals.
Mm-hmm. Yep.
Also, Will Price could have voted for this and then made another proposal to make it, to limit it to 1 year.
Yeah, so that's the interesting part too. Like, this proposal only covers to like 9,999, and then what? Like, does it go back to like if nothing else was done, would it go back to needing 10 nouns at that point or 5 nouns because it got extended to the 400? Like, it's going to get adjusted over time anyway.
I assume
it
would revert to the percentage that's in the protocol. Yeah, so I guess it could be like it says
setting the proposal threshold to 1 would require 2 votes again once we pass 9,999 nouns in roughly 26 years.
Okay.
Right. Yeah, it doesn't revert back to default. It just has a percentage and you have the...
Yeah, then it would be 2 and 10,000 until 20,000 and gotcha.
How did that ever get on the table? Why would you want to require more than one noun?
Well, like 142 said, like as the community grows, and remember that this was baked into the protocol from early days. So the idea was that the DAO would be inundated with proposals and would not be able to keep up with governance. And so raising the difficulty level by a percentage point, is a good way to moderate that over time. But counterpoint, like 142 also said, is we haven't really seen that inundation, even though definitely props are up compared to like 8 months ago, but it's not like it's something that we can't keep up with, and there hasn't been a huge problem with spam, so it does kind of fix a problem that wasn't
really I believe it originally comes from compound. We forked the compound governance, the governance of compound protocol, and there you have millions of tokens, so you don't want anyone who buys one comp to put a proposal. That's why the percentage and number of tokens that you must have. So that's the reason you have this by default baked in.
That makes sense. Thank you.
And what's interesting too that I think about is if it stayed at what it was originally, 1 every 100 nouns, then that technically by the end of 1 year you're going to have to own like 3 nouns to put a proposal in, and if they're going for like say 150 grand worth of ETH at a time on average, then you're going to be spending nearly $500,000 USD per year just to be able to submit proposals.
Indication
of exactly how much nouns would go for before the project launched.
It
to be successful, but they didn't know it was going to be what it is.
No, that's right. Exactly. It's just a hindsight thought now. Like, as we discuss and decide what to do into the future, and like even right now, if it was to be 10,000, that means you'd have to spend, if we're just saying a rough average of 150 grand or 100 ETH or something like that, whatever we want to average it out at, then that's every 3 years basically. That you got to spend. So like that's kind of a 30, 40 grand a year wage just to continue buying a noun every 3 years to be able to propose at the rate of today.
One devil's advocate comment that was made by Noun's co-founder 9999 in the Discord was that if you have an idea that you want to be successful on chain, you're going to have to convince a lot more than one additional nouner that it's a good idea.
Yeah.
But having said that, I do think that ignores the friction point, the point of like it being just frankly more difficult for people to get an idea on chain to see what people think. So
I think there's something kind of interesting about the social aspect too, that I think Goldie was kind of mentioning, of like there's something kind of cool about, you have to at least talk to one other nouner, and maybe that like forces more community. It's interesting.
Sure. There's a counterpoint to that. I think that it makes it less permissionless. You have to have some social skills, or you have to have some friends, and you need to like be a Discord person. You need to speak English, and you need to like do so many things that you need to be able to do it in order to make noun friends. And if we want to keep it permissionless and decentralized, then let's say there's some noun in Japan that doesn't really speak English, has a really amazing idea, wants to make a visual proposal, not even text, and they don't have, you know, all these like social cues of and culture of Americans, or, you know, so like they, and they don't have these skills. So they're kind of like censored in a way.
Yeah, that's a good point.
Yeah, it's another, a great counterpoint.
Another thing I was going to mention about this too is that this is probably like the most alarming raise too, because it's 100% raise from 1 to 2. So like every other raise in the future would be probably less of a big deal, even though it'll still be a big deal. But like, going from 1 to 2 is like doubling the amount of nouns, right? Whereas, you know, next time it'll just be 30% more, et cetera, right? I don't know.
It does make a difference over time. And I think that's why it keeps getting, like, the can keeps getting kicked down the road, a sense, because it's like, it is such a big jump and suddenly it's double. Like, and eventually, once that double settles in over time, whether that's in 100 years or 26 years or what, like, that eventually I'm sure it will settle in at some point. And at that point, then the next one to come around, yeah, it's not as bad. It's half as bad again, I guess, each time.
One thing I will say is I'm surprised, 142, that there was no discussion of this in the lead up to it happening. And I know it's a permissionless protocol, but there was no announcement, no nothing in the Discord, not even like a note to nouners to say, P.S., you know, you need 2 nouns now to propose. And there was no discussion about whether it should be allowed to just tick over or whether a proposal should be made to change it. That was a bit surprising to me.
Yeah, that's the power of defaults, I think. It's the power of defaults. Like, it's just defaulted to that and like no one cared. So just moved on.
But now somebody does care. But it took a little bit.
Yeah, because I was looking through the docs as well, and there was a few conflicting points. Like, one still said you need 1%, and then another one said you need 0.5%. And I was like, so what is it? We don't know until that 400 ticks over. And then it was clear. It was obvious at that point. But yeah, it's super interesting, though. And I do think an increase over time is an interesting model. But yeah, I think it's too soon. Like, we're only a year old, and I think the prices that, in hindsight, that they're going for doesn't really warrant the need to keep increasing how many you need to propose. But I've abstained so far because I'm still pondering this whole thing.
Yeah, I was going to say, I think that this is, you know, it's definitely the first time I've seen it. I was going to actually check out the Xanadu blue, you know, prop as soon as it got posted, and then saw this one. So, you know, again, I even if there was conversations around it, I definitely was not privy to those prior to. So I definitely think that this conversation is going to continue, because now that it's been brought to the table, everyone gets to discuss, okay, well, until what now, or until how many years, right? So,
yeah.
You know, we'd love for all of you guys here to get involved. This is something we will get to vote on. It's currently live. If you go into our Discord, just on the channels on the left, proposal voting, you'll see it there. Prop 134 is our new post. I'm looking at it now. I would love to see some votes come in while we're in the space. It's really.
Hey, what happens with that, Aptoshi? Why would they vote? What's the point?
Well, whichever way the vote goes, be that a yes, a no, or an abstain. Those are the 3 ways that you can vote. We will use Noun 142's noun and place that vote on chain. So we will actually, on 134, be counted as a vote. Oh, it's looking like that's live now. Oh, so, okay. So 32 against so far with 3 yeses. This is definitely going to be a conversation that's going to continue and probably shift a little bit. So,
yeah, it'll be interesting to see how it goes. I mean, we haven't seen any big blocks vote yet, I don't think. I don't think we've seen the Nounders vote, and I don't think we've seen any of the other big blocks. We've seen, when I'm looking at it, it's actually, funny enough, mostly Nounders that own multiple nouns, which kind of makes sense, I guess.
Will Price voted against.
That's true. Oh, yes, he did. Yeah, okay.
Big block.
One big block. One big block, and then some other individuals who own multiple nouns.
Yeah, I predict this is not going to pass, and then we're going to have a new one that will
expand. Well, I also think, like, you know, who could have imagined what nouns would have looked like a year later, right? We can't imagine what it's going to look like a year from now. The second I'm hearing noun 9,999, I'm like, what? That's going to be an entirely different, you know, whole setting going on.
We're going to be thousands old. Of,
you know.
Well, here's an interesting.
The threshold has also passed quite easily a few times. And so I agree that if this was for a year, this would have passed with no real problem.
Yeah.
Interestingly, and anecdotally, 142, I'm just noticing that the three votes for already are all very brand new nouns. We've got deployer. We have forgeries with the stereo, and we have whoever bought the cute kitty from last week. So these are all nouners who joined the DAO within the last 4 months. So I think that speaks to like new nouners coming in and maybe some of them being like, wait, what the heck? I can't even post a prop anymore.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Obviously,
yeah, it actually might be a negative influence on the price of nouns because it makes it less attractive to buy a noun today.
Yep, yeah. True. I'm curious how Prop House is affecting this whole scene, too.
How so?
With fewer proposals actually going into the on-chain for the NounsDAO, but now all these people can prop over on the side that would have been here.
I don't know if that's actually happening just because of the difference in scale, typically.
In the amount, yep.
Yeah. Like, I haven't seen really any slowdown. If anything, I've seen a pickup in on-chain proposals since nouns Prop House went live, and even the big houses they're so specific with their mandates that I think that they're rooting out proposals that wouldn't otherwise come live, like all the proposals that we got for the alternate front ends, like the one that 142's working on. I doubt most, if any of them, would have even materialized. Like 142, you probably wouldn't have made that Snowberry and Deployer, unless it was a mandate, right?
Yeah, that's exactly true. So I think Prop House is actually has increased the supply of proposals. So basically increasing the market, which is amazing. And also a bit cannibalizing from small grants, but I think mainly, like, I don't know, 90% are proposals that we would never have seen.
Right.
There's an interesting argument that in the future, like, you could almost say, like, anything run through Prop House. Like, I'll fund your project, but like run it through a prop house and like see if everyone else has the same opportunity to do this at the same cost, if yours still comes out on top.
100%. I think prop house is the major innovation that has come up from nouns. And also, by the way, 9 o'clock, this show by itself is kind of a mini prop house if you think about it with our contest.
Yeah, exactly. And we're in the process of moving those literally over onto prop house infra, so it will be even more true very soon.
Yeah, it's like a competitive small grants prop house situation where we're going to leverage prop house for two different angles as well, for team funding and for contest funding.
Yeah, we run it every day. We run prop house every day.
Zarg, what were you saying?
How do we expand out? Like, if we're sort of like a prop house for art, how do we expand out into building and larger things?
I think it's very easy. So, like, that's part of the reason why I wanted to move our contest voting over onto Prop House, is because it opens up the door in the future. If we wanted to do, you know, we're going to do our contest as we have been doing, for example, and the cleanup contest and all this stuff. But in the future, if we've got that Prop House up and we can vote on it with our tokens, which will be live pretty soon, there's nothing that will stop us from saying, you know what, let's do a community Prop House for 9 o'clock. Anyone can come up with any kind of infrastructure or, you know, Prop House prop of any kind that would proliferate nouns and help the Noun Square community grow. And we can just do a competition like that using the same infra. So that's exciting to me in the future.
That is exciting. And we've talked about incubation too, and I wonder how we might get involved in helping incubate some of the builders who come through our door.
Well, funny enough, some people have already been putting kind of technical projects in. Like, I'm thinking of Chris Co-Created, who built that clock. He built a clock that always shows the 9 o'clock time in your time zone, and it's like a little web app. He built that as an entry for an art contest, and so I think there's already a demand, I think, for people who want to actually just build things. Yeah,
it is cool. We need to get that up.
Yeah, I just need to build a clock face for it.
I do love Chris Co-Created's clock. I just made the Discord, our Discord, the most recent pin. So go ahead. it's easier than ever to just click that and then go into the proposal voting channel if you want your voice to be heard. And you should want that, because we have been gifted this noun from 142.
He gifted it to us? That's amazing. Thank you, 142. Yeah.
It's a permanent delegation. I don't know if they'll give that 142. It's on the blockchain. We can't help it. I'm sorry.
Soulbound delegation. Soulbound. And just a reminder, we do use humor on this show sometimes.
No, we do not.
While you're out there doing all your research and reading early in the morning, there's two other props. We don't have voting live for them in our Discord, but you have to look at these ones, I believe. Mm-hmm. Prop 135, Xanadu and Nouns mega episode, plus the real times Nouns world toolkit.
We got an early alpha drip on this one, didn't we?
Oh my gosh. Oh, yeah. Such early drip. It's discourse early drip. Blue was actually on our show. Maybe we can do a cool post as soon as we're doing live voting. Maybe we'll like retweet that space so people can listen back. But
I think we can do a big live vote for this on Monday's show.
Okay. Morning. Yes. That'll be so much fun. If you go in there, he actually has a video, so you can check out what he's got going on. But he wants to do some very cool things in the metaverse. A specific metaverse. I don't know. He does like these really cool 3D things. And it's funny. I think someone else was telling me that about him and saying that this person was their like hero when it came to like 3D stuff. And then I got to tell that person that he was a guest on our show. So again, we have
amazing,
crazy alpha things happening here at the Noun Square all the time. Alpha even just meaning you get a 1 week's notice prior to anyone else about maybe something that's happening. So that's definitely alpha for me in anything Web3.
Sign up now by following the Noun Square for free. Lastly,
also, there's founding partners of NFT Seattle. Go check that out. That was on Discourse for a while.
Interesting thing about that one, Aptoshi. That's mm-hmm. one of the first posts that is first proposals as being actually sponsored by Nouncil, but did not come from a Nounciler. So Nouncil, one of Nouncil's big goals is to be a more accessible, democratic way for people to get proposals on chain if they don't own that one noun or now two nouns in order to get a proposal on chain. So they came and they spoke to the Nouncil about their idea and put a vote up about whether Nouncil would sponsor their proposal. The 90 Nouncilers voted to do so. And so that's why you see, if you go to nouns.wtf/vote/136, you'll see proposed by nouncil.eth. So that's kind of interesting.
That's awesome. I think we're definitely going to start seeing a trend more towards these IRL things that came up in the Nouner call the other day. You know, I do Nouns OTG, and so I love the IRL everything. So I'm excited. I don't think there's ever going to be a cap on IRL events that Nouns can be at. So specifically, NFT events are always a go for me. I think that one would be great, and I think it'd be great to see some NFT shout-outs up in the Pacific Northwest. Love Seattle. I actually spent like 6 months there one time. Very rainy, but pretty cool town. Everyone's either rocking Seattle Seahawks gear, or they are a like young 20s male programmer for Amazon.
There's no in-between?
No. That's what that entire town is made up of. Amazon has more buildings in that town. There were more cranes building new buildings in Seattle than there were in New York and LA and Miami combined for the last couple years, because Amazon has just completely basically taken over that town. But
this has been random facts about Seattle with Aptoshi.
Yes. There you go. So they actually have the first stores that are the Amazon stores where there's no tellers or anything. Just scans you and then scans like all your barcodes and like whatever you bag up when you leave, and you just walk out of the store, and then it charges your Amazon account. So
interestingly, though, it's funny. I don't know if it was worthwhile for them to do so, because as soon as they opened their first brick and mortar store, all of a sudden the next day Walmart announced that they were revamping their online store and all these new features and everything. So I think Walmart saw that and they're like, nah, that's my territory. If you come to my territory.
Yeah, Walmart's where people come in and put stuff in bags and just walk out. Duh.
Yeah, for those in the audience that don't know what a brick and mortar store is. It is where you used to go inside.
It's something from the before times.
That sounds horrible. You could get moved.
Before the drones delivered all of our goods directly to us wherever we were in the world.
Oh my god, no, it's weird. It's almost like a weird, like Stepford Wives, but all of Seattle, but for Amazon. Like everyone's front porch has an Amazon box on it at all times. And I really mean that. I don't know how it happens.
Yeah, it's crazy, hey.
Their Amazon trucks have bathrooms on them so that the drivers don't even have to stop.
You know what's crazy?
That's terrifying. In
Australia, it's we don't get, like, you know, stores in the US and Canada and that, you can, like, spend all day in there. They're designed so you don't leave. Like, you got little restaurants in them. You can go to the bathroom there or the washroom, depending on which country you're in. In Australia, none of that. Nothing like it. You ask for a bathroom, like, no, sir. No, not here. No, you can't, like,
buy your things
public,
and leave.
Public bathroom nearby? Nope. You're like, oh, all right, so I'll go home then. It's crazy.
Yeah, in fact, in North American stores, especially the big box stores, they purposely make no two stores the same. So if in my city where there's, you know, maybe five Home Depots, every Home Depot, every Walmart is purposely a different layout. And it's because they have data that shows that wandering lost people buy things. So
yeah,
my first job in college was at Bloomingdale's, and one of my, like, literally what I was just a shopping cart with charisma that, like, would take people around to, like, we had restaurants in the store. And
various introducing laughing around. Cart.
Yeah. We're just walking around, like, drinking champagne and being like, yes, you should buy this thing. So, yeah.
It's crazy, eh? Oh, man. We need that for the Nouniverse. I guess that's us.
Where's Nodes? We're doing a little bit of branding, which you're going to see soon. We've got some interesting stuff coming up. We need to do one of those branding cards that says, we are the Walmart of Nouns.
Oh, God. Maybe not.
I mean, it's no worse than Semi-Solids, is it?
Maybe not. Hey, you know what?
It's about the level of Semi-Solids, I'd say.
I'll never bash a Walmart. I'm not above Walmart. I'll walk into Walmart tomorrow.
I love Walmart. I just don't know if I want to be Walmart.
This episode of the Noun Square is sponsored by Walmart.
I probably prefer to be the Costco restaurant where you get all the mad wings and dollar hot dogs or whatever they've got there. I love the wings from there and the pizza.
Yeah.
Have you ever just gone to Costco just to go up and down the aisles for the samples?
Yeah. Oh,
100%. Talk about the before times.
Just like you were bored and it was just fun.
That was definitely the before times, though. You can't do that anymore. They don't have samples.
Oh, yeah.
Anymore.
I can get behind being Costco. That's pretty fun.
Costco.
Yeah. I like Costco. I used to do everything I could there. And then if I couldn't do it there, I'd go elsewhere as a sub choice.
Come get your Nounish vibes in bulk from the Noun Square.
Yes.
Exactly. Bulk vibes every day. Now,
bulk vibes.
I like that.
Bulk vibes.
Now I need a Noun Square infomercial. When can we make this?
It's Nouns Club.
Are you in need of
Nouns Club?
Do you have a specific trait in mind?
We've got every time slot down, like as we drift through the night and the day, we've got every time slot for every different type of infomercial. It's perfect.
Well, I do kind of like these morning ones. I'm gonna really start loving them probably as we push it just one more hour, and then I'll just be banging. But oh, Toadie, you have a song.
I have a song.
I missed the Poe app,
and I have also a Poe app.
I also had a song. We'll play this one tomorrow. I can't wait to hear yours. And we do have a Poe app. Duh.
The last two times this happened, Aptoshi, the song we both had queued was the same one. So I'm curious if this one.
Yeah, yeah, I like that, actually.
We'll see. Let me know. But yeah, Ben, actually, Ryan's here. Ryan is not on stage, so we should bring him up.
Yeah, we've been trying to invite him up, and he can't get on for some reason.
Oh.
He has not great Wi-Fi right now, but I do have the pop sound if someone else has the word.
Yeah, yeah, I've got it under control. All good.
LFG.
So if for any reason you still don't understand what a POAP is or how to get one, you go to POAP.xyz. It'll explain all the details, but it just proves that you're at an event, and this event being our Noun Square Lite edition for the weekend. And once you've got the app, you just open it up and hit the mint button, and then you hit the secret word button, and then you type in the word. No sounds? I don't have the sound.
Oh, I have it. Wait.
Fast FOMO or fast FOMO.
Sorry, can you say
fast that
again?
FOMO.
Can you say that fast again?
FOMO.
Yeah, your American accent makes me just die.
By the way, can I just make a comment that the awesome POAPs that have been done by World of Noun by JM are yes. pretty cool.
Take oh my a look God, in your amazing,
app. He's got like this.
They're a little bit behind at the moment, but they'll all get uploaded, I guess, as soon as I've got all the artwork. But yeah, once we've got all the artwork, it'll be all uploaded. But we've already got three there, I believe. And then three to find out what they look like. Oh my God.
Oh my gosh, and I almost forgot too, but I did pull a Twitter picker for the retweet of the room, and so I'll announce that as well.
Woohoo! Who's gonna win? Who's gonna win?
Parker underscore ETH one. Let's go. I'm gonna give you
Parker underscore ETH one.
Is he here?
He's here. Yeah. He's down there. He's got the hat. Student crypto, loving it. Thank you so much. I did see that you were here this entire space. So thank you for hanging out with us, especially on the weekend show. I can't wait to hear what you got coming up for us, Toady, with this song.
All right, you ready? You ready for this?
Yes.
All right, let's go.
Step into the fantasy. You are not invited to the other side of eternity. They call me an alien, a big
is it the same song?
Again.
Thank you, everybody.
Lead in with Riri. Outro with Katy Perry. What else do you want?
Dope spaceship.
Rihanna, Katy Perry combo today?
Yeah, this is great.
You know it.
Where are the new iHeart?
Do it live. Thanks for tuning in, guys.
Bye.
Yeah, thanks for coming.
Thank you, everybody.
Thanks for hosting, Optoshi.
Bye, guys.
Optoshi, how are you emoting on both of your accounts at the same time?
I don't know. That's scary. I'm not doing that.
Eek.
Yeah. Twitter?
Yes.
Twitter.